So,
this is a new Fender Squire Telly, Butterscotch Telly. It's going to be the basis for five-string electric banjo converting. First one will be just getting rid of this string and using these five positions, five pole pieces, five adjuster saddles, and five of the tuners. It's brand new. So, still got the sticker, still got the cover, still got the tag. This is not the valid way to look at this, but this is .0025. We're showing a bow. So, I'm gonna start messing with this thing. You can't blast off from a shaky foundation. We need to make sure the frets are level. We're also gonna take the biting edge off these frets. That's how we do it in the Navy. This one's going away. No tension on the neck. Isn't that wonderful? Look at that. Sucker's flat. Flat from the factory. Within plus or minus 2 thou or better. I didn't even use this. I might have deep. Pretty good guess. Okay. At some point, I'm going to remove these edges, but theoretically, banjo, five strings, will be G, D, G, B, D. Electric guitar. E-A-D, G-B, E. Okay, here's the G, here's the B. The E, we want to make a D. Also keep in mind that these strings are really wimpy. Is like a 9 and a 12, which isn't even the right gauge for these things, but this is theory right now. This is a real wimpy string. It's going to become our G string. And the A, that's the fifth place, will become this high egos. We're gonna put another string there and leave these two just because we can. Eventually, these may become thicker, slightly heavier gauge. But right now, getting rid of the E. Throw them away theoretically. Let me get rid of this A. You don't need no stinking A. There's our D, G, B. Gonna need about a 10 or an 11 there. This one's going. Now normally, this sucker is going to be an E. But remember, like on your, what's the scale length? I think these are 25 and a half. 25 and a half, just like a Martin. So you get a big Martin, E string is 13. This little 9 will easily attain the note G instead of E. That's 3 frets higher. Now, this is kind of bent, so I might have to fight with it or use a new one. Come on, man. This is going to be the hardest part of the whole job. Come on. Oh, come on. Hooray. That'll go up here. So, we've scrounged it. 12 and maybe a 15. We're just hooking the string. Now technically, we will tune it. Plug it in and see what we got. So far, we took off the fat E and threw it away. We took off the A string and threw it away. Took this skinny high E, put it here where the A used to be, put a slightly fatter string here. This is a 9, we put on a 10 or 11. I'm thinking this is going to be a little wimpy. Basically, the scale is an inch or two shorter than a 5 string. And the gauges are even lighter, but it's an electric guitar. You can get by. I would up these gauges, but this is the theory that we're dealing with. I'll tune it up and check the action and see if we've succeeded. So, it's 10 o'clock. People are sleeping, but well, I got it turned up just a tad. This is phase one. Next, we have to set it up. We're just proving the concept right now. We're going to have to set the intonation and the string height maximum. But the concept is here. Thank you. playing just like a five-string banjo. The notes are the same. So, as I said, we'll work on these. Part of that is to pull them this way. This again is phase one. For some people, that's all you need. If this is intonating correctly, and you like the string spacing, you get an extra five notes by not having the thing anchored here. Normally these are the same gauge, and this one's anchored five frets higher. For me, I want the neck about this wide. I want to spread the strings out more. Maybe not quite this much, but I really like it wide down here. And phase one would be to get rid of this. Redrill these, take this out, use another one of these, and move everything to the middle, including five new grooves, most likely. And that would be the next phase. If you want to really make it into a five-string banjo, we actually cut this back, just in back of the fifth fret, put the tuner here. It's not needed, as long as you can get away with a 9 or possibly a 10. Now, you can use the same gauge and simply pin the string here, still keep the tuner. And that may be where I opt, because it'll give you the exact same string reaction as the acoustic five-string banjo. Okay, bye.